Hey guys, and welcome back. I hope you are doing great. I'm Mohsen and I want to show you how to use view binding in the Recycler View adapter. If you are ready, give me a thumbs up, hit the subscribe button and the bell button, and let's get started. To make the video shorter, before I start recording, I've done some required things. Here in the build.gradle, I have added build features, view binding true, and I've synced the app. Then in the main activity, I've done the stuff for the view binding, just like this and this. I've initialized the created latent variable here and binding.root as the layout. In the activity main, I have added a recycler view, just as you see. And I have created a layout for the recycler view with only a text view, just an example. RV underscore item underscore row is the name of this layout. And now in the recycler view adapter class, I'm going to show you how to use view binding. I have written some codes here to show you the old fashioned way, using find view by eyes. First of all, in the onCreate view holder, we are writing these two lines to set the layout, which is the RV underscore item underscore row, to the recycler view. And then we can use the items, the widgets, the elements like this. Just create a val and the type of it, and then item view dot find view by ID. Now we don't need this. I'm going to comment it if you want to compare this later. And you can find the source code in the GitHub page, and the link will be down below in the description box. So let's start here from the class view holder. Here, instead of item view, we are going to write binding, and will be this one. Remember to create the layout first, then come and create the recycler view class. If you do this, the SDK automatically will create this class for you, RV item row binding, based on the name that you are giving to the layout. And here, instead of item view, I'm going to write binding.root. Then here, Twitter, RV item binding dot inflate, and here layout inflator dot from parent dot context, and then comma parent comma false. Okay, that's everything here. And now in the unbind view holder, we can use the elements so easy, just like this. We will write holder dot binding dot, and the list of the IDs of the widgets will appear here. And here now I have only a text view, so I can use the text view and change the text of it, set a text of it on it, or maybe set onClick listener on it, and do whatever you want. Equals to just like this. Okay, that was everything about this video. I hope it was useful for you. If you find this content satisfying, please give me a thumbs up to help this video be watched by more people. And if you haven't subscribed the channel, please subscribe the channel to support me. Thank you very much. Bye bye.